harmonic motion has a time period of 0.2 second and an amplitude of 0.4 centimeter. So two parameters are given here, time period and amplitude, T and A. What do you need to find is, find the maximum velocity and acceleration. X dot is velocity, X dot equal to A into omega n. A is known as amplitude. You have amplitude, A is 0.4. And what is omega n? Natural frequency. How to find frequency? Frequency equal to omega n equal to 2 pi divided by T. What do you mean by T? Time period. You can divide this parameter. You will be getting 31.42 radian per second. The frequency will always be in two units. What are they? One is radian per second, or it will be in terms of hertz. So you can write it in radian per second. Why? Why not hertz? Is you are substituting in terms of 2 pi. Pi is a parameter which related with radian. So for a full rotation of a circle, if you have a circle and you have a radius, for a full rotation of the radius, it has 3.14 of units. So this is a circle and it is measured in terms of radian, 12.6 centimeter per second, and your maximum acceleration will be 394.8. A system vibrating with a natural frequency of 6 hertz. Now the first point indicates you have a system. What do you mean by system? You should understand like this. This is the exact practical structure. Now a system means you will remove the column and write it as K. You will add all the column and write it as K. You will add all the mass coming in a beam and write it as M. In which direction it is moving? It is moving in forward direction. This indication is called as a system. Like that, in any problem, they have given some parameter. You should know to understand what is happening in the problem. A system is vibrating. You can understand a spring is there and a mass which is vibrating in 6 hertz. What do you mean by 6 hertz? Per second, it is vibrating 6 times. Okay. With an initial amplitude of 2 centimeter. So they have given A of 2 centimeter and an initial velocity 25 centimeter per second. Determine the natural period, first one. Amplitude is A, natural period is T, maximum velocity, that is V suffix max, maximum acceleration is X max, and phase angle which is phi. Also write the equation of motion of a vibrating system. Now what are the given datas? You should know what is F. F, X dot and X. Three parameters you know. Now let us find the first parameter called natural period, which indicates T. What is the formula related to T? T equal to 1 by F. You have frequency here. 1 by 6. You will be getting the time period. Now what is natural frequency omega n? Omega n is 2 pi F, which is 37.7. Now by this you can find amplitude. 2 square plus 25 square divided by 37.7 square root. You will be getting 2.11. You can try third parameter. Maximum velocity. Now do you know amplitude? Yes, you have amplitude. How to find velocity? A into omega n. You have both the parameters A and omega n. Both are available. You can multiply to find maximum velocity and maximum acceleration. Now your maximum acceleration will be 79.44 and maximum acceleration 2994. Note that your unit should be when finding the velocity, it should be in centimeter per second, and finding acceleration is centimeter per second square. Now next formula is phase angle is phi. Formula is tan inverse of x dot omega n divided by x dot. Tan inverse of x naught is 2, 37.7 divided by 25. 71 degree, 39 minutes, 23 second. Also you can write in terms of radian. Here you have the cantilever beam. One end is fixed, other end is free. And carrying a mass of 500 kg at its upper end. Find the natural period and natural frequency. They have given E and I. E in terms of kg per centimeter square, I in terms of 1300 centimeter power 4. Now in this problem, what are the given datas? Length L they have given, mass M, Young's modulus and I. You need natural period. Now before going to a problem, you should know to draw this one. By the given data, you should assume and draw the figure. A fixed end at one side, other side will be free, which is carrying 500 kg. Now for any dynamic problem, you have to make it as a system. What do you mean by system is drawing in terms of this mode. Parameter of stiffness and mass. Now this is called stiffness and this is called mass. Now you know the free body diagram. You can detach this into a free body diagram. This is external force. You have two inbuilt characters. What are they? In order to resist the motion. If the object is moving one side, these are the two internal forces which resist. What are they? Mx double dot plus kx dot. How to find k? K equals 3ei by L cube. For a cantilever beam, k is known as stiffness. What do you mean by k? Force which requires to cause unit displacement. This is derived from slope deflection equation. The parameters are in different units. E and I is in centimeter power 4. You have to make this as centimeter power cube. Instead of 3 meter, you can write it as 300 centimeter. 303 kg per centimeter. Now you can write in terms of Newton per centimeter by multiplying kg into 9.81. In derivation, I have said you that stiffness should be in terms of only one unit. What is that? Newton per meter. Why? Acceleration due to gravity will be in terms of meter per second square. Hence, you have to convert into meter only, all the parameters. So, you have to convert kg centimeter to Newton meter. So, for converting kg to Newton into 9.81, from centimeter to meter, 1 by 100. So your answer will be 2.97 into 10 power 5 natural frequency. Omega n equal to root of k by m. Your k is 2.97 into 10 power 5 divided by 500. Omega n equal to 24.37. T you can find it. What is CPS? Cycles per second. You can write in terms of radian per seconds also. Now if you know F, you can directly find T. 1 by F is T. 0.26 second. Books are the key to knowledge and books are the key to change yourself. And they want to get into some place or some dimension. But they don't know the path. The path is given in direction and it is written in terms of words. And most of the religious scripts are written in textbook only. There is no other way to understand. So book is a dimension which can take you to different levels. you should select the book. Why most of the people are afraid of books, particularly students? Why the students are afraid is they don't know how to approach the book. See, all the books are not same, and if you need to understand certain concept, you should go sub levels and complete that straight away. You cannot, even though you know, when you are playing some game, you cannot straight away jump to last level and play, get the rewards. You have to go level by level. That is the way the game is also operated. Same way, how you can change yourself and how you can become a good technologist is, you should know the books, number of books. Whatever subject you are studying is different. Who guided you is very much different there. And according to the guidance, you will get the knowledge. This information I have collected from 4 number of authors, and the author will have their own mode of taking the readers, how they take the readers and how they take to their level. Each and individual is different. Some people can jump, some people can walk, some people can just move slightly. So you should know your level and you should select your